What's up, everybody? You know it is Goody Beats, guys, and I actually had no intentions of filming today, like no intentions. Talked to Preston Bear the other day, and Nick Bear is getting into town on Monday, so we want to get some epic shots, some epic drone footage here in Austin. And by the way, I do apologize for this lighting. I'm here at Hop Daddy's, as you can see. Just got my burger, waiting on him. We got to find some parking garages to get around Austin and get some epic drone footage, because I think they want to put together a pretty good video. I haven't got the details yet, but I said, shoot, I'll tag along, I'll help out, why not? Fly the drone, help out my buddy, hang out around Austin. I mean, why not? Why wouldn't you do that? I just called Nick Zelfing too to come and meet us, so I don't know if Nick Zelfing's gonna meet us or not. But I'm gonna dig into this burger, as you can see right here. Not gonna have the buns, gonna take the buns off and just eat the meat. But as soon as Preston gets here, I'll show you what we're doing, show you everything we're gonna, like, everything I'm gonna eat, drink, whatever. I'll show you all of it. I don't know how long this video is gonna be, because I do, like I said, I had no intentions of vlogging this day whatsoever. But anyways, gonna dig into this food. Everybody just sit back, relax, and enjoy this drone day. So just got done eating at Hop Daddy's, and look what I got. Nick ended up coming out to meet us. Just still waiting on Preston Bear. Just got a text from him, and he said traffic is absolutely terrible. So we're gonna find this parking garage, which is like just around the corner, get the drone and get some epic shots. So here we go. Yeah, I ended up getting one. Nick brought me one. Clutch. What's up, dude?
Is that the Phantom 4? What's going on?
Yeah, it's Phantom 4, man.
Dude, are incredible.
You got a bomb in there, man? What you got in here?
This is the, what's it called, Nanak case. My brother got this. This thing's a beast.
Nice.
One break in there.
All right. So, here's gonna be the DJI app. Whoa. What's up, buddy? Is there the song? Anyways, guys, don't forget your memory card. I've got this thing up in the air plenty of times, and I'm like, oh crap, no memory card. Don't make a rookie mistake. So me and Preston Bear are gonna race our drones, maybe get some battling going on. Guys, so we just got done flying the drones. What you think, man? That's pretty cool. We got pretty
awesome.
Close.
Good footage, yeah. Close to the city.
If you saw the footage, Preston's drone and my drone got pretty damn close. Yeah. It was pretty scary there for a minute. But right now we're gonna walk around, probably grab a beer and call it a night. So in search of some beer. Let's go. Everybody, so just got here to Home Slice, and me, Nick, and Preston were thinking about where to go eat, and I know they want pizza. I cannot have pizza, but that's fine. I am gonna have one beer though. I wasn't gonna record the rest of the night, but we literally just walked into Home Slice right now, and Preston just pretty much told me,
First out.
He's never had home slice pizza. And how long have you lived in Austin?
2.5 months.
Oh my god, man. This is insane. You guys are gonna witness Preston's bare virginity, home slice virginity broken tonight. So I think that calls for me having a slice of pizza. I don't know.
You can't eat that keto pizza again.
Maybe I'm gonna ask them if they can make me a keto pizza here.
Awesome.
Alright man, so we're here. We're gonna witness Preston Bear have his first home slice pizza. This is crazy.
This is unreal.
It's madness. Madness. Alright guys, so just finished home slice pizza. Preston, what you think, man?
Some of the best I've had. Best pepperoni I've had.
Nice. Nick? Oh, dude. Nick ordered a pie.
I got two pies.
Alright guys, so that's going to conclude this video. We'll definitely see these two lads more often. And you might even see someone who looks just like him pretty soon.
Couple days.
But that's going to be it, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Peace. What's up, everybody? You know it is. Goody Beats, and welcome back to another vlog, guys. So, I think where we last left off, we may have left off in Austin on Friday night when I was with Nick Zelfrin and Preston Bear. Now, today is Sunday. Didn't record anything on Saturday because I had a wedding to go to. It was pretty busy, and so I couldn't really film because I wanted to, like, you know, be in the moment, have fun at the wedding, not really worry about vlogging. But right now, heading up to meet my dad. We're gonna shoot some guns today. It is Sunday, like I said, so shout out to the Cowboys. By the time you guys will watch this, the Cowboys would already play Green Bay, so hopefully they win today, so looking forward to that. Also heading up to my uncle's a little bit later on today for another family gathering. So again, really no plans as far as like what I'm gonna plan. I'm just gonna wing it like I always do. Put it together for a vlog and then show you guys. But everybody just sit back, relax, and enjoy this full day of vlogging. Peace. So there may be gun people who watch my channel, not gun people, but people who know a little bit about firearms. And they're probably gonna ask what I shot, you know, what kind of gun was it, blah, 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 things that I don't even know, but maybe you would, you could tell them. So that first gun we shot.
The first gun we were shooting a Bushmaster 223.
Bushmaster 223?
And a 5.56 or a 223 caliber.
Okay.
It is a Bushmaster, it's an M4, kind of like what militaries carry, but it's for civilian. It's got pop-up sights in the back. And it's got a flashlight and a laser, green laser for night vision.
Okay, these are all things that you just added custom to to the railing, right?
Yes.
Correct.
Added all this railing. Added. I took off the stock, the original stock, grip up here, and I put this up here for a painted T rail, so that I can put a grip, a laser, and a flashlight on this side.
Okay. Anything else? Modifications?
Yeah, put a grip, a whole grip in the back, so it's real soft. It's a lot better than the hard one that it comes with.
Okay.
And comes with an adjustable rail. That's still stock.
All right. So that's what we shot the first time. All right. Now tell us about the very loud gun that we shot the second time.
This is a 10-inch barrel with an SB15 grip on the back, designed for single hand shooting, like a pistol. This is actually a pistol and not a rifle.
It's actually considered a pistol.
Yes,
considered category.
A pistol. Categorized a pistol, yes. And this is designed to fit on your arm, but
why is it considered a pistol? Because most people look at that, they're going to say that's an assault rifle.
Yeah, so they're going to say it's designed as a pistol because the length of the barrel is short, and if you took this off, it would just be a tube back here, so it would be an actual pistol. But because this new design, the SB15 TAC from Sig Sauer, it's designed to go around your wrist, and I'll show you. It's designed to go like this. For veterans that come back from war who had an amputee arm, whether it was right or left arm, they would still be able to shoot an AR-15 with one hand, with a pistol. But it also makes a great stabilizer when you're shooting with your cheek. And I ended up putting up pop-up sights in the front and back, rear, front sights and rear sights. Added a flashlight up front here for night. And it's basically the same thing as an AR-15, designed as an M4, but in a smaller package. And it makes it a lot louder. Without it, this is what the pistol would look like. Let me show you. This is what a pistol is. You'll see them everywhere. Gun dealers or academy, or not actually academy, but at a gun show.
Okay.
But I put this together. I built the, it's got a stock, I bought it separate. I bought the barrel separate. And I put all the innards in together, with the trigger, the safety, the firing mechanism, everything, design.
So would this be considered a custom gun, custom made gun?
Yes, it would be, because I did build it myself.
Okay. And all right. Now, what about the third handgun that we shot?
Third handgun. We were shooting. It was a Glock 40 caliber, a Glock.
Okay, let's see.
27.
Okay.
In a 40 caliber, and that is my carry gun that I carry at all times. It's designed. It's got an extended magazine on it for a better grip. It's a great gun. It's got a little bit more power than a 40, than a 9mm, and it doesn't kick as much as a 45. The reason I like this is because I can carry up to 14 rounds, 13 in the magazine and one in the chamber. And most 9mm nowadays are designed to carry 7 or 8 rounds like a shield. And I just don't think that's adequate enough ammo if you only have one magazine. 13 rounds is a lot better than 7 rounds. And this is a 40 caliber. And that is my carry gun. And it's a good gun. And it's a Glock.
All right. So those are the three guns that we shot today.
Yes, that is correct.
Oh, by the way. So after shooting all these guns, the number one tip that you recommend that you do immediately after you shoot is what?
Clean it.
And that's the hard part.
That's the hard part.
And that's probably the one thing that most people don't even think of.
It's time consuming, but it needs to be done, because an AR-15 is piston driven. It's not piston driven, it's gas operated. So the gas comes up and it builds up, and eventually it'll gump up your bolt, and it'll jam on you.
Okay. And I guarantee 9 out of 10 people who don't know much about guns just think you just get a gun, you shoot it, and that's it. You put it up.
No, and that is why originally, when I first got a gun, I bought the Glock. The Glock is designed for that. I can shoot this Glock 500 times and just wipe it down with a rag, and it's ready to go. Mm-hmm. I can leave it outside in the mud, let it rain on it. I can pick it up the next day and it'll still shoot, because that's what the Glocks are designed to do. I wouldn't recommend you do that, but for those people that don't want to clean their guns, go with a Glock.
Okay.
That's the way to do it.
Easiest way. But definitely your AR-15 and your other custom gun, you got to clean.
Yes. You got to clean them.
Alright, so we're cleaning up, getting ready, packing up our stuff, but one tip, because I wanted to keep firing some bullets. Actually, I wanted to keep firing until we were all out, but this is what my dad just said right now, so go ahead.
Very important that when you shoot, whether you shoot it at a private firing range, a friend's private firing range, like this person I'm shooting at my brother's house, we're allowed to shoot out here. However, neighbors may not appreciate you shooting out there, and they may wait till you finish shooting to come confront you. They may be angry, they may come at you with a gun. That's why it's always important not to leave the firing range without at least a magazine loaded. Because in the event that somebody does come up to you and want to argue, at least you have to be able to defend yourself with another magazine. So it's very important. Don't leave the firing range or anywhere. Don't ever leave without having rounds in your magazine. So that when you...
Alright, so there's a...
go home, you gotta use it again.
Another pro tip. So again, things that I just... people like me who are not really... we don't know too much about firearms and not really into guns as much as, you know, like my dad, I'm into fitness, so he doesn't know too much things about fitness and tips and things like that. The do's and don'ts, same thing for me when it comes to guns. He's been around guns all his life. You know, it's something that he's into, it's his hobbies, and so I don't know too many things like that. Like, if it was me, I would have fired every single bullet I brought, but again, you don't ever think about things like that.
Always bring binoculars and a toothpick.
Cheating on Romo. Alright guys, so what I'm having right now is about a quarter leg, I believe is what it's called. And then I got a couple of pork strips, as you can see right here. Gonna dig into this food, continue to watch the Cowboy game. They're doing great, hopefully they continue. And yeah, we'll see you throughout the day. Guys, so family's pretty much, everyone's getting ready to leave. It is Sunday, so everyone's got to get ready for work and school. But this whole, this little get-together was for my Aunt Libby. It was her birthday. It was a surprise birthday. She had no clue. That's why we did the little surprise when she got here. So really good turnout. Again, I love doing these little things on the weekends with family members. I mean, that, like I told you this before, Monday through Friday, it's like constant grind. Work, 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 work. Gym schedule, you know, just got to take care of all this crap you got to do throughout the week. But on the weekends, man, that's when I like to spend time with the family. And if you guys are OG subscribers to this channel, you know that I'm always here on the weekends. Like, I'm always doing, like, videos here at my uncle's house. This is kind of like the get-together place that we always hang out at. But yeah, had a pretty good Sunday, man. Cowboys won, got to shoot some guns, got to spend time with my family, ate some good barbecue. I mean, what more can you ask for? I mean, there's really not much more you can ask for. Weather was great here in Texas, so yeah, had an absolute blast. Hope you guys like this video. I'm gonna put it all together tonight. So today is Sunday. I'm gonna go home right now, edit this video, and have it up for tomorrow on Monday. But if not, then for sure Tuesday. And it is gonna be a variety of things. So we had like Preston, hanging out with Preston on Friday, no filming on Saturday, and then the vlogs today. So see, I can put it together. I'm pretty sure I can. So anyways, if you guys did like this video, give it a thumbs up, always helps out the channel. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, man, and we'll see you tomorrow. Peace.